Hi everyone, this is Alex with Plugin Connection, and in this video we're going to take a walk through the BX Digital V2. The BX Digital V2 is a latency-free 11-band stereo EQ and stereo de-esser that works in several modes, among them two sophisticated mid-side modes for mastering and microphone settings. The V2 is based upon the modern classic BX Digital V1 and the analog BX1 EQ, which was developed as a high-end analog EQ in 2006. One of the most useful features of any of the Plugin Alliance plugins is the ability to access the manual directly from within the plugin. On the bottom right-hand corner of the plugin, you'll find a help button. You can just click on this and choose Open Manual. And this comes in handy because this allows you to navigate through all the information that you need about that product. And this is common for all the Plugin Alliance plugins. You can access the manual directly from the plugin. Another helpful tip is being able to switch between mid-side mastering and dual mono by simply choosing that here in the middle section of the plugin. In dual mono, you have the left section controlling the left side of your stereo and the right section controlling the right side of your stereo. Along with this, you can click on the link button and link the bands. So when I'm making changes to the right side, it's also making changes to the left side. When using the mid-side mastering mode, you have the ability to solo the mid or the side sections independently. And this allows you to hear stuff inside of your music that you might want to correct. For example, I can solo the side, and I can choose to apply a filter. Or I can choose to make a cut around the frequency. I can also do that with the solo mid.
But now I can see that you left a note explaining to me.
You can easily store up to 4 settings within the Brainworx BX Digital V2, and the settings are located at the top, labeled A through D. So if you're happy with your EQ adjustments, but you just want to experiment with a different setting, you can easily copy and paste that to another slot. For example, I have settings A, and choose copy, go to B and choose paste. Now I've copied what's on settings A to setting B, and I can start tweaking from here. This is also a great way to store up to 4 presets within the plugin and recall them in a mastering session. The BX Digital V2 also comes with a mono version that can be used on individual tracks in a mixing session. Here, for example, we're going to use the de-esser to adjust the SS on our vocals. For that, you simply press solo, you crank up the threshold, and you sweep the frequency.
Well, you had to go, but I disagree.
Once you find the frequency that you want, simply adjust the threshold to where you're shaving off the peaks of that.
You hit the road, hit the
de-esser.
Explaining to me
and turn it back on.
Why you had to go.
On the mid-side version of the plugin, you have 2 de-essers, one which will adjust the de-essing to the mid and one to the side. And this can be useful to reduce harsh frequencies on a stereo field. Here, for example, we can reduce the harsh frequencies of the hi-hat and independently from the mid signal. Another useful feature is the bass shift, and this is an intelligent EQ band for the bass frequencies of your mix. It's called the bass shift because 2 different frequencies will be shifted against each other with a turn of just 1 knob. Here, for example, I can crank up the bass shift on the drums to enhance the kick. And I can go to the bass instrument track and do the opposite. This is what it sounds like before. And after. You can also link the mid and the side channels by using the link button. Using the stereo width makes your mix wider by increasing the stereo width, or you can decrease the stereo width by reducing the ambience. Let's listen to what happens to these strings when we decrease the stereo width. At 0% is fully mono. Let's go the opposite direction. So you can now hear how the strings are on the outside stereo field of the guitars, just by simply turning one knob. When EQing, sometimes you want to find the resonant frequency of an instrument and reduce it. And the BX Digital V2 allows you to auto-listen the frequency, the Q, or the gain. You can enable the auto-listen button and choose what you want to auto-listen. If I choose frequency, anytime I click and drag, the frequency is going to solo that for me. Once I find the resonant frequency, I can choose to boost it or cut it. You can also bypass the individual bands by clicking on a band name. This is what it sounds like before and after. If you change the auto listen to Q, frequency, and gain, anytime you adjust any one of these knobs, it's going to auto solo that for you. So that's all the time that we have for this video. However, you can download a fully functional 14-day trial version of this plugin and many other plugins from pluginalliance.com. As always, we welcome your feedback on the comments below and would love to hear your favorite features on this equalizer. Thanks so much for watching.